sleep.
Hanging out here at the Enterprise for the car. Gonna get a ride from a trail angel.
Back at it.
Yep.
Slow down, you move too fast. You got to make the morning last. Just kicking down the cobblestones, looking for fun and feeling groovy. La-da-da-da-da-da, feeling groovy. Hello lamppost, what you knowing? I come to watch your flowers growing. Ain't you got no rhymes for me? Do it and do-do, feeling groovy. Da-da-da-da-da-da, feeling groovy. I got no deeds to do, no promises to keep. I'm dappled and drowsy and ready to sleep. Let the morning time drop all its petals on me. Life, I love you, all is groovy.
Bye, Desert. We're gonna wish bid you adieu.
We've had enough.
It's been nice, but we're not sad to see you go.
Lost in the desert.
Thank goodness.
Check out the new digs. Last section, the poles on my Big Agnes Fly Creek Platinum got all bent out of shape at night. We were in a windstorm and it was a really unpleasant night's sleep. And when I woke up the next day, the tent was just warped. So
tent envy is real. That thing is amazing.
Yeah, Kevin says he's got tent envy. Check this out. Doors on both sides of the tent, so it's super versatile. It's huge. This is the Big Agnes Tiger Wall. I can't even fill the space with all my gear. I'm so excited. And
you need another cowboy in there.
Yeah. This is a two-man that I would say is actually like you really could fit two people in there. So Kevin's over there getting ready. He's getting his tent set up.
It's a tiny tent.
He's a little jealous.
I'm a tiny house liver like on HGTV.
Whereas in my tent, I can actually sit up tall. I can brush my hair in the tent. I can like stretch my arms out. I did not know what I was missing out on clearly. So it was a blessing in disguise. Another thing that's really handy is that the zipper, it actually opens down and then up the side. Just makes for a really easy to use, minimal tension. It's just a really nice tent. Wow, just made so nicely. I love it.
You've been good, old friend. Hang in there. Maybe I'll retire you at the Sierra, but you know what? I'll give you the nod. If you wanna play on to the Sierra, I'm with you. It'll be your choice, old dog.
So it's the craziest morning. I get up, take a look at my trekking poles, and they've got these just bites and chunks out of the strap. See if I can zoom in here. Look at that. I definitely didn't have that last night before I went to bed. Kevin said he saw a little, what was it that you said you saw, Kev? I didn't bring my poles inside of my tent last night. So I'm assuming that it was attracted to maybe the salt from the sweat on the trekking pole straps. So, oh well. I might have to get some new trekking poles though if I want to be able to use those straps, which are really handy. No more complaining, lesson learned.
Definitely really pretty through the desert here. One final push, 40 miles until Kennedy Meadows. Yeah. I guess we're a quarter of the way. Wow.
Come on up here.
Whew. At long last, not too far away from the top of the climb. It's a hot one today. Kevin's not too far back. You can see where the trail has gone. Whew. And even down there at that saddle, it was still less than one third of the way up. Whew. It's been a doozy, but it's beautiful. I have no words right now. Some amazing trail angel dropped off pop, and there was an orange pop in there for me. Oh, I'm so excited. My voice is a little weird right now. I feel like I'm battling a cold, but honestly, being out here, it puts a lot of wear and tear on the body, but orange pop, yes. You want to hear about a new game I've been playing?
Yeah.
The game is called Just Make It to the Next Shade Patch.
I was thinking that same game earlier.
So here we are in a beautiful shade patch now, and I was like, you know what? Just got to make it to that one. Then I just got to make it to that one, and then there's more around the corner. So
we're lucky to have shade.
We are.
It has not been too bad, really. I mean, all things considered.
Yeah. Bugs are swarming.
State of the trail.
State of the trail address.
Hell yeah. We got up early this morning, battled the forklifts.
We need to explain the forklifts.
There's spiders with these two little spines on the front that just seem to be able to lift things up.
It's like a cross between a scorpion and a spider.
And they blend right in with like little sticks and pine needles. So when we set up camp last night, we knew we'd be battling those.
Mm-hmm. I had at least three of them on my tent at one point. It made me very anxious.
Even though they're like two inches from my face, but I, you know, that's the beauty of the tent.
Absolutely. Reason number 407 why I will not cowboy.
Because there's 407 critters per square foot.
Most perfect campsite tonight.
Oh man, what is it ever?
My tent there, Kevin's tent just right here over this rock, and the South Fork of the Kern River flowing right next to us. Oh, it's a dream.
Great sight. Beating the desert to do. It's been 700 miles of lots of fun, lots of sand, but lots of beautiful scenery, nice people, trail angels. It's been great. Big moment alert.
Kennedy Meadows. Oh.
Coming up on it.
It's been so hot today. It's like you can see the heat rising from the ground.
The desert gave us one final swift
knockout punch.
The uppercut, the Mike Tyson. So, coming up here. Pretty neat. Epic.
Woo! Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Shake your booty. Shake your booty.
Just came down off that beautiful hill from the woods. Now we're kind of headlong through this meadow towards the next mountain and the Kern River. I think there's a pretty bridge coming up here. Wow. You're seeing it, I'm seeing it. This is an awesome break here at Cow Creek. You wouldn't think that Cow Creek would provide great water, but very good Wawa.
It is, let's take a look.
Cool and clear. This uphill isn't too bad yet. There's been some steep parts, but this has been pretty gradual in here. Been nice, so it's warming up. There are bits of shade. Okay, Shannon's putting on her sun hat. It's about high noon.
Taking a little pack off break. Mid-climb, we're rocking it.
It's a good one.
Yeah, I think we're getting up to about 10,000 feet with this climb, and then we're not gonna be dipping too much below 10,000 from here on out for now for the next couple hundred miles, I think.
Pretty cool.
I'm still coughing, but...
Surf's up, dude.
Dope views. Climbing, climbing. Still going up.
Kev's way up there. Just gotta keep climbing to catch up with him.
There's that meadow Jeb and I hiked through this morning. So you can see how much elevation we're gaining. You can see Shan down there, ready to come up. And it looks like beyond this is just more up.
Well, it doesn't get much better than this. Got meal cooking in there. Seasonal stream just ahead, drying out our sleeping bags, and there's Kev.
What's up? Filtering some water.
That's right. Look at this. Wow. Oh man. There's Mount Whitney right there. Here, let me zoom in and get that better. Wow. Holy smokes. We're gonna be on that.
Here's Shannon. She hooked up for her fly. We think it's upside down. But it still looks cool.
Rookie mistake.
No, still looks awesome. There's my tent. Thought about going flyless, but it's a little chilly. So, I'm cold averse. Beautiful sunset there. The sky is turning pinkish. Gosh, you can see some other people tenting up here. It's just beyond this little creek, the seasonal creek that's going. So, Shannon and I veered off the path. It's an unmarked, we just found a site. I think someone had tented here before, but nice secluded area. A little buggy, not too bad.
Good morning to you. This is our new routine. Here's what we do. We get up, we hike 2 to 3 miles. We have our morning coffee. We love that morning coffee. It is just everything.
It's not quite a drip, but it will do.
Let's be real, it's not gourmet, but it powers us up the climb at hand. We're listening to some tunes.
What we got next, Shane? What are you calling for? A little more rap?
Yeah, give me some whiz. Kevin just had some oatmeal. My famous oatmeal, if I do say so myself.
It is so good. I'm going to have to learn how to make that because I think we're running out of it, aren't we?
Yeah. I only made enough to get us through like the desert in the first part of the Sierra.
Battling fire ants.
Yeah. Song update.
Little Wiz Khalifa, top floor. Good song. Been a really nice climb. Shannon and I shade hopping. Jamming a chorus line. Always a crowd pleaser. You can see the trail. Let's see. Behind me there. And the views out here. Oh, unbelievable. Snow-peaked mountains, pine forest. Wow.
All right, I'm using my map here to try to point out Whitney. It is this one right here. Right here. Not too much snow up there. It's not this snow-peaked one. That's a pretty one. And then I don't know what all these are over there, but I believe it is this one right here. Let me see if I can zoom in on it.
Owens Valley down below there, the center of water politics here in California. We've got an issue.
I have no water. We are a little under 2 miles to the water source. No big deal though, because we're almost at the top. Then we're all downhill to it. So, you know, Shannon loaned some to me. Thank you so much. I'm carrying it. I'm gonna enjoy about a little under a half liter, so that'll easily get me there. And we're gonna just tank up our guzzlers and just, you know, just hydrate. We don't wanna get that altitude sickness. Eagle warned us that someone got airlifted off for altitude sickness, so we gotta keep hydrated. So
oh yeah.
I'm glad Eagle doesn't know that I'm waterless, but thank you, Shannon, for sharing.
I know you can't see how steep that is. It doesn't look very steep on camera, but it's been like a Stairmaster today.
Oh man, my legs are so freaking tired.
We're pretty tired. Not too much further.
High five. Made it to the top.
Oh, 10,800.
Really?
Time for a Triscuit break. They're a little crumpled up, but it'll do.
I'm doing some dark chocolate covered cranberries. Yeah! That's so good. Sun's still pretty high in the sky. You can see our nice tent site here. My tent on the right, Shannon's on the left. I've got my bear can there. Here we go. There are skeeters. If you blow on it too, I think that helps. I don't know, huh? Watch a master at work.
Kevin.
It's looking great. Yeah, Shan.
Thanks for your help. Hello.
Yay. First fire, pretty freaking cool.
Can't think of a better way to spend our last night on trail for this section.
Our first fire.
Love it.
It smells so good.
It does, it just is perfect.
Now it started a log in there.
Beautiful sunset starting. And this amazing fire. Kev's capturing it too.
It's dope. Walking here along the path to Diaz Creek, a little off the trail, 0.2 off the trail. Definitely not feeling so hot today. It's our last day before we head in, actually a week off here. I'm going to Denver. Shannon is hanging with Andy, Santa Monica. It's gonna be awesome. Very proud. We've done a lot of good miles. It's been a bug. Oh my gosh. With all the hikers hanging out at Kennedy Meadows and hygiene is difficult on the trail. So I think bugs going around a little easier. So, I don't know. Be excited to get these last few miles done and hopefully recover in town. So, can't wait to talk to Bren. Haven't talked to him in a few days. But we'll get a wrap and catch up. Almost the trail pass.
Woo! It's yeah. Gonna be great.
Yeah! Ridge crest, here we come. Normal food.
Oh.
Woo! Holy cannoli, my goodness. I'm pretty blown away by the beauty here. Go get him, Tiger.
So trail pass is that way from where we came. This way leads to Cottonwood Pass. I think this is some kind of equestrian route. And this takes us to Horseshoe Meadow.
We are in the Golden Trout Wilderness in the Inyo National Forest.
I love it.
We were actually just in Jenny Lake's wilderness.
It was beautiful.
Yeah, it was pretty.
They're stealing all the water from the
Yeah, exactly.
Eastern Sierra. Shuttle.